Talking about the supernova 1604 and how the Vanuatu inscription described it. And the interesting thing is very nice adjectives are available, and that is how the Milky Way has been described there, and like a fire in the Milky Way. That's the kind of adjective. Now I'll tell about other serendipitous results that emerged out of this study. I had studied about these three agnis that are used, and I found that this is the type of description that is usually given in all the texts. But I had found that the Shulbha Sutra calculations were not giving this as a symmetrical thing, and the picture indeed was available in a copper plate inscription. I had worked out the particular angle of this Dakshina Agni and explained that either because of the change of the latitude of the person or because of the movement of the this particular thing, the line that I have drawn here is as per the specification given in the Shulbha Sutra. So this is one interesting thing I found in a copper plate inscription from Swarnavalli in Sonde. And I also found that the lifespan of Sri Ramanujacharya, as can be inferred from the stone inscriptions, can be only 77 years instead of the understood 120. But I cannot comment on this because there are many authentic biographies written on him, and that declares it as 120. And the other interesting thing was, when was zero written with this symbol as we all know it today? That was another interesting thing. As we know today, the earliest record of zero is from an inscription found in Gwalior. And another was found in Cambodia, and that is a little earlier to this. So here is the zero. This is how it is written, and this is dated 683. This is also from Cambodia. And recently, yet another one has been found much earlier to this. That is from Assam, and it is between 2nd and 3rd century. So here it is. So this way, when they started writing zero, this also was a very interesting thing that came out of this study. So the stone inscriptions that way have been working out to be a new treasure house for scientific studies concerning the motion of the earth and the moon, and as records of planetary conjunction, and for special events like supernova, one has to search very carefully. And for the evolution of scientific methods in other fields, mathematics, mensuration, for example, how the scales evolved in India, and for environmental studies. Nowadays, people have taken this also as one of an interesting study. And I mentioned about various papers that have come out of this. This is the book that I mentioned already, and some of the papers I am showing here are published. They are available online, so those who are interested can read these papers. There is the next one, some other papers. They are published in Current Science and JOAHH and so on. So I have, see, for example, Records of Supernova from India in Current Science, Records of Ketu in Current Science. And these two in Vatipatha and the thing they have put in IJHS, the bulletin of the INSA. And of course, the most recent is the one which combines the eclipse record from India and China. And this is published in this book as a chapter. And so I conclude with this, and